गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ निशा रायते, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, KTHM कॉलेज, नासिक। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सब्जेक्ट BOUT 232, डेवलपमेंटल बॉटनी। एंड फ्रॉम दिस सब्जेक्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डील विथ 3 क्रेडिट्स, क्रेडिट फर्स्ट, क्रेडिट थर्ड एंड क्रेडिट फोर्थ। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्रेडिट फर्स्ट एंड From this credit, chapter first and topic first, basic concept of plant development. And in previous lecture, we can study about what is the potency, what is commitment, and what is the specification, the processes of plant development. And today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the plant processes like induction and competence. Students, now what is potency? We can study in last lecture. What is potency? Potency is the power or energy to generate plant organ or whole plant. And what is commitment? Commitment, that is the overall changes in cellular biochemistry and functions are preceded by a process resulting in the commitment of the cell to a certain fate. And the process, that is the specification. Specification, the fate of a cell or a tissue is said to be specified when it is capable of differentiating autonomously, that is the itself. Now today we are going to discuss about what is induction and competence. Induction, the inductive processes play an important role in the developmental botany or development of multicellular organisms. Induction is the effect on the developmental pathway of one group of cells by substance displayed by or emitted from another. In plants, the phenomena is commonly referred to as floral induction, and this is fit broad definition of an inductive processes. The induction can be broadly defined as the effect on the developmental pathway of one group of cells by substance displayed by or emitted from another. The inductive processes can be defined as cells within the growing tip of the plant switch from a vegetative to a reproductive mode of development in response to a signal emitted from cells in another location, for instance the leaves. That means the induction is the signal, or the signal passed through from growing tip of the plant and switch from a vegetative to reproductive mode of development. This signal passed through the growing tip from this growing tip, and it is passed through all over the plant organ or plant. That is the induction. The inductive signal involved in flowering can travel over a long distance from its source in the leaves to the growing tip. And the growing tip of a plant shoot is a population of a stem cells. Stem cells, you know that in plant, what is stem cells? That is the meristematic cells. Meristematic cells, the cluster of cells or group of cells, they can divide or redivide, or undifferentiated cells. The formation of plant organ or plant part or whole plant, it is called as the meristematic cells. The meristematic cells in plant, that is the stem cells, referred to as the shoot apical meristem. These stem cells referred to as a shoot apical meristem, that is the SAM, that give rise to the tissues of the above ground part of the plant. In the first phase of the plant life cycle, the SAM forms primordia that divide and differentiate into the leaves. Now, See this diagram, shoot apical meristem. See here, procambium. The formation of xylem and phloem. Xylem is the water conductive tissue and phloem is the food conductive tissues. Then ground tissues, that is the parenchyma, cholenchyma and sclerenchyma. Then leaf primordium, formation of the leaf primordium. Here protoderm, protoderm, that is the formation of epidermal tissues, root hairs, trichomes. And here leaf primordium, in between this leaf primordium and apical meristem, that is the axillary meristem. The shoot apical meristem produce stems, leaves and reproductive structures. In addition to the shoot apical meristem initiated during the embryogenesis, the axillary shoot apical meristem, that is the axillary buds. See here in diagram, in between the angle of leaf and stem, the formation of a axillary buds. And these axillary buds is derived from the original one from in the axis, that is the angle between the leaf and stem. Unlike new root meristem, these arises from the surface layers of the meristem. Root apical meristem, the formation of first root cap apical meristem, then procambium, ground tissue, protoderm, root hairs, pericycles, that is the formation of endodermis and lateral root. That is, in the first phase of the plant life cycle, the sam forms primordia that divide and differentiate into the leaves. Upon the floral induction, the sam forms primordia that develops into the flower. That is the floral induction, that is the signal passed through the growing tip. From this growing tip, this signal of floral induction passed through leaf or leaf primordia. That is the induction. And the inductive signal involved in the flowering can travel over a long distance from its source in the leaves to the growing tip. And in this respect, the inductive signal behaves more like a hormones or groups of hormones. The shoot apical meristem SAM have three developmental phases, that is the juvenile phase, the adult vegetative phase and the adult reproductive phase. The transition from one phase to the another is called as phase changes. Phase change, that is the cell or meristematic cell pass through the juvenile phase, then juvenile to adult vegetative phase, and then adult vegetative phase to adult reproductive phase. That is the transition from one phase to the another phase is called as the phase changes. The difference between juvenile and adult phase is that adult phase have ability to reproduce. And what is juvenile phase? Juvenile phase cannot, the plant cannot reproduce. It is called as the juvenile phase. Then, for example, Arabidopsis thaliana, it is the perennial plant species. These phases change growth pattern and body form. Now, the signals promoting or inhibiting flowering can move from the roots, cotyledon or leaves to the shoot apex, where meristem competence determines whether or not the plant will respond to the signal. Leaves may also need to develop competence to respond to environmental signals before they can produce floral promoters. Once the meristem has switched over to the adult phase, only the adult vegetative structures are produced and culminating in floral evocation or floral induction. The environmental factors also affected in plant development, such as light, temperature and waters, etc. Plant growth and development depends on program formation of organs from multipotent cells, which can be organized in discrete meristems such as the apical, root apical meristem and shoot apical meristems, or scattered within the different tissue of mature organs. The environmental cues such as the photoperiod or temperature regimes are an integral part of this program plant development. That is, the environmental factors influence in plant development, and also the phase changes can be influenced by nutrient, gibberellins and other chemical signals. The transition at the shoot apex from the juvenile to the adult phase can be affected by transmissible factors from the rest of the plant, and in many plants, exposure to low light conditions prolong juvenility or causes reversion to the juvenility, and it causes regeneration, that is the reversion to juvenility, that is the condition that retard growth such as mineral deficiency, low light water stress, defoliation and low temperature tends to prolong the juvenile phase, and again reversion into the adult phase into the juvenile phase. In contrast, condition that promote vigorous growth accelerated the transition to the adult phase. In some species, the juvenile meristem appears to the capable of flowering but does not receive sufficient floral stimulus until the plant becomes large enough. For example, in mango, that is botanical name of mango, Mangifera indica, the juvenile seedlings can be induced to flower when grafted to a mature tree. These phase changes can be influenced by nutrient, gibberellins and other chemical signals, that is exposed to a low light condition prolong juvenility because of low light result in the reduction of supply of carbohydrates to the shoot apex. And gibberellin also affect the phase change, sometimes promotes maturation but sometimes responsible for the rejuvenation, that is the again adult phase transmitted into the juvenile phase. Then leaves and meristem that are competent to respond to flowering signals have undergone a juvenile to adult phase change. The internal and external factors regulate whether a meristem produces vegetative or reproductive structures. One type of involved in the environmental factors, that is the plant have evolved a complex set of regulatory pathway to control when this floral transition occurs. This regulatory pathway are two general types. One type involves pathway designed to sense environmental cues such as change in day length, temperature or soil moisture. For example, many plant species have evolved photoperiod, that is responsive pathway. Some species are induced to flower by long days, whereas the other species flower earlier in response to short days. And second class of pathway are those that involve the state of development. For example, many plant species must pass through a juvenile phase during which they are not competent to initiate flowering. These developmental pathways are often referred to as autonomous to indicate that they are not sensitive to environmental cues. And the extent to which environmental response pathway versus autonomous pathway control flowering varies among the plant species. That is, the internal and external factors regulate whether a meristem produces vegetative to reproductive structures. That is the induction. Induction, that is the signal passed through the growing tip, and from this growing tip the signal passed through all over the plant part and from growing tip to leaves, and leaves or leaf primordia, the induction of a floral flower. Then competence. What is competence? Competence is the ability to do something successfully or efficiently. The floral eucation requires the apical bud to pass through the two developmental stages, that are competence and determination. The life cycle of flowering plants can be considered as a succession of distinct growth phases, and the transition between these phases is dependent on developmental genetic program, that are the trigger and modulated by both environmental and endogenous stimuli. That is, they following the germination and before they become competent to flower and reproduce. The shoot of most plants pass through a phase of the vegetative growth. During this period, plant generally rapidly increases their photosynthetic capacity and their size and mass. This vegetative mode of growth can be further divided into a juvenile and adult vegetative phase. That is, competence is the ability to do something successfully or efficiently. The floral evocation requires the apical bud to pass through these two developmental stages, that is the competence and determination. Now, what is the relation between the vegetative and reproductive maturation? That is one of the most confusing issue in shoot maturation, is the relationship between vegetative and reproductive stages. In most plants, only the flower when they are in an adult vegetative phase, but the timing of flower production varies widely relative to the timing of vegetative phase change, and some plants flower immediately after this transition. Others remain in an adult vegetative phase for a long time before flowering. For example, the tobacco plant. If a vegetative extensive studies in tobacco have demonstrated that floral evocation requires the apical bud pass through two developmental stages, that is the competence and determination. One stage is the acquisition of competence. A bud is said to be competent if it is able to flower when given the appropriate developmental signal, that is the induction of flower. To initiate floral development, the cells of the meristem must first become competent. The cells of meristem, from growing tip, the meristematic cell pass the signal through all over the plant pot or leaf. That is, this plant produce the flower. This is the signal or induction from the meristematic cell to all over the plant pot or plant. That is, the meristematic cell become competent. A competent vegetative meristem that can respond floral stimulus, that is induction, by becoming florally determined, that is committed to producing a flower, that is determination. Determination, the plant having or plant produce flower. The induction, that is signal pass through meristematic cell all over the plant, this plant can produce flower, that is the competent. This meristematic cell is competent, and commitment, that is the they can produce flower. This is the commitment and specification, they can able to produce organ or tissues, that is the specification to a certain cell fate, and the plant becoming florally determined, that is committed to producing flowers. The determined state is usually expressed, but this may require an additional signal. Now see this diagram. If vegetative shoot, that is the scion, the scion grafted onto a flowering stalk. Here this scion is grafted on this flowering stalk. Here, see here, this is the root stalk. This root stalk ability to produce flower, and this scion grafted on this root stalk, and the scion flowers immediately. That is the competent scion. The scion having flower immediately. It is demonstrably capable of responding to the level of floral stimulus present in the stalk and is therefore competent. Now further, or this scion is grafted on this root stalk. The failure of the scion to flower would indicate that the shoot apical meristem has not yet attained competent, that is the non-competent scion. Thus, the juvenile meristem of herbaceous plant are competent to flower, but those of woody species are not. This is the process of competence. See this diagram. The vegetative growth, the maize plant, competent, that is able to respond in expected manner when given the appropriate developmental signals, that is the induction. The signal pass through growing tip, from this growing tip to the leaf or all over the plant part. Photoperiodism, that is induction, the signal pass through the plant part, and then determine able to follow same developmental program even after emerge from its normal position in plant. Then some hormones are also affected or influenced on the plant growth, and then express the apical meristem undergoes morphogenesis, that is the formation of morphological character, that is here. See this plant, formation of leaf, stem or root, or having a flowers. That is the processes of competent determination is the next process in plant development. The determination of plant development we can see in next lecture. Determination and differentiation. Thank you.